I love M&M's and Skittles, but they do have a common problem, which is with these candies there is just so much color, so much diversity. What if, just hear me out, they were more sorted into straight lines? Yep, that's better. Since it's 2022, machines do everything for us, and I do suddenly have so much more extra energy. So I used it to create this thing. I call it Get Cancelled Machine. First thing I had to do is figuring out a way to pick up candies one by one. For this, I designed discs with holes slightly larger than the candies. The candies sit on top of the first disc and drop to the second disc one by one through the white tube. The second disc turns step by step to show each candy to a sensor, and then drop the candies to the containers through the red tube. With this principle, I designed and built this robot. Now, with a way to physically sort the candies, robot needed to figure out what color they are. The easiest way to do this is with an RGB sensor, but I wanted to use a webcam since I have a couple of them lying around at home. With this sensor selected, the first algorithm that I tried uses RGB color space, which works by assigning 3 values for each pixel of an image. These values are red, green and blue, and they have a range between 0 and 255. Here you can see different colors and RGB values that represent them. But since an image is not unified, I needed a way to find what the main color is on the image. Let's take this 5x5 image for example. For simplicity, there are only 4 colors on the image. What we can do is summing red, green and blue values of all pixels and divide the sum to the number of pixels to find the average RGB value of the image. Now, how do we decide what color is this value? The way I did is by imagining RGB as 3D coordinate slot X, Y and Z. In this 3D space, we can use preset locations of each color that we want to sort and compare the distances between them and the average RGB value of the image. Then we can assume the smallest distance is the correct color. At least in theory, it works. But in reality, this did not work very well. The main problem that happened was the stepper motors that spin the disc would get stuck temporarily, and the candy would not stop at exactly the right location. In this case, the average color of the image would be pretty much black, since the disc is black. So I made another algorithm that would work even if the candy is slightly misplaced. This time I used HSV color space, which again uses 3 values to represent a color. These values are hue, saturation, and value. With HSV, hue basically determines what color the pixel is. Here, you can see by adjusting the slider, only the H value changes. With HSV, instead of finding distance in 3D space, I used filters for each color. What these filters would do is turning all the pixels that satisfies a condition white and turning everything else black. The condition for each color is a different boundary. Here you can see I can separate the colors by changing the highs and lows of the boundary. So I found boundaries for each color and created the filters. Each image gets filtered for all the colors and turned to 7 different black and white images. Then what the algorithm does is counting all the white pixels for each of these 7 images. And the one with the most white pixels is the one that is masked by the correct colors filter. Now that the robot knows the correct color, a server drops the candies into the correct container. The only thing that has left is figuring out what to do with all these candy boxes. I tried to play Jenga, but the first player always seems to lose.